get this.
Okay, we are starting recording. Okay, we'll go ahead and call the county council meeting to order by standing in the public meeting. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Roll call, please.
Weagle, absent. Varga, absent.
Varga is here.
Oh, Varga.
Electronic.
Okay. Middleton?
Here.
Crowder?
Here.
Ivano?
Present.
Thank you. You have the minutes from the April 23rd meeting. I believe we have a quorum enough to approve those. So any concerns about the April 12th meeting? I'm sorry, I said April 23rd, but on the minutes it says April 12th. So I think it's the April 12th. So, any issues with that?
I do not.
Okay, hearing none. And Tad, you were absent at that meeting. So you were, okay. Do I have a motion to approve the April 12th minutes as presented?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. Further discussion? All those in favor, show that these will sign. Jenny, Jennifer, and Will approve. And Tad abstains. Next up, we actually don't have enough for the May 10th minutes, I don't believe. Oh, actually, we do.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. I'm sorry. So, questions or anything regarding May 10th minutes? Okay. Can I have a motion to approve the May 10th minutes as presented?
Summit.
Second. Motion by Jenny, seconded by Walt. Sorry, Tad. Okay. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. Tad, Walt, Jenny approve.
Abstain.
Jennifer abstains. Okay. We have postponed Jason Meyer to another day because we have so much hitting today. So the first thing we're going to hit is Ordinance 2022-12. I think, let me make sure.
Yep.
Yep. Do I have a motion to read by title only?
Second.
Motion by Jane, second by Jennifer. Further discussion? All those in favor, should believe you'll sign. It is unanimous of those present. Please read Ordinance Number 2022-12 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-12, vacation of public right-of-way.
Okay, you'll remember that this is on North Oak Street. There is a property owner that owns both sides of this alley. The alley doesn't really go anywhere. So it's just a vacation of that alleyway. So, question, Peck, I'm not even sure it's an improved alley. I think it's just just a plot, but not improved alley. So, questions regarding the ordinance? Okay. Can I have a motion to approve Ordinance Number 2022-12 on second and final reading?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jenny, second by Jennifer. Further discussion? We'll go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Oh.
Sorry, I have to do voice vote because that. So, Jenny?
Approved.
Yeah.
Approved.
Well?
Approved.
Ted? There you go. So it is unanimous of those present. Okay, now we're compliance with statement of benefits time. Dale's favorite time of the year. So, Dale, do you want to talk about kind of just in a nutshell what you've kind of done in preparation for tonight?
Yeah, I would. Well, we don't have anybody here. Drew Johnson, who was here, wasn't here, but it's all so, but I'd like to start with. So, first of all, decision, you know, I did a field decision just a couple of weeks ago with the state, what things are really happening over there, the investment is coming, you know.
Titan?
Titan decision, yeah. So, you know, very impressed by that, unless you take a lot of decision. But then, Kyocera, who comes into the year, is the kind of outlets, because they have a purchase of the building, whatever. And we'll probably inform council, not the next meeting, but the year after, because they're going to be still a whole investment and capital improvements. So, still within the city limits. So, to me, thinking, so with their, see that one, it's very, very well. That's kind of, for everybody that was on, for a little time, you know, I think they're all doing fairly well. There's some specific questions, or maybe you want to talk to someone about that, but sort of reject that out of those folks.
I have a question. Do we change over the name of Precision Plastics?
So, that's a very good question. Because, you know,
I questioned the treasurer about this and her assessor, and she said because this was last year's payable this year, it was still decisions, and so it won't take effect until the next.
Okay.
So this one going forward, because of the sale, probably is no longer.
Yeah, she said this one's okay.
Okay.
Any other questions? Tip Ted over. He is going to have a headache by the time this is over. I'm going to try to make this a little better. Thank you, Bruce.
Like I'm on a boat.
On a boat. Okay. Okay, with that, then I'm going to go ahead and go through in the order that it's in our packet. So the first one is the Columbia City Solar Array, which is IMPA, effectively. You can tell that the actual cost and assessed value is up fairly significantly from what they were estimating. So any questions about the Columbia City Solar Array LLC?
That's just for equipment, right?
It's a personal property abatement, yeah, correct.
Okay.
Yep. Okay, hearing none, can I have a motion to approve Columbia City Solar Array LLC and grant an additional year of abatement?
Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. Further discussion? Voice vote? Jenny. Jennifer.
Approved.
Walt.
Approved.
Ted.
Aye.
It is unanimous. Okay. Next up I have... quality inspection engage. This is a personal property abatement. Any questions regarding that one? Okay. Can I have a motion to approve quality inspection gauge personal property abatement and grant an additional year of abatement?
Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. Further discussion? Go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad? It's unanimous of those present. Next up, I have Rindley Properties, and this is for real estate. Which I think this is also QIG, right? That's what I thought. This is the real estate part of quality inspection gauge. Questions on that front? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve for the approve Rindley Properties LLC and grant an additional year of abatement?
Approved.
Is that a motion?
I'm sorry. Yes.
Okay, go ahead. Second. Motion by Jenny, seconded by Jennifer. We go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. next up is Casey Jones Plating. As you'll remember, Keith, that came last year. I'm sorry. I was fidgeting with Chad. If you would, did you mention anything about Casey Jones?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I apologize. Okay. Questions regarding this?
What page?
I'm sorry. Page 35 of your packet. It's a personal property abatement for Casey Jones Plating. Okay, do I have a motion to approve the approved Casey Jones Plating and grant an additional year of abatement?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, second by Jennifer. Further discussion? Do the voice vote, Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Chad? It's unanimous of those present. Next up is the real estate abatement for Precision Plastics of Indiana. Questions on this one? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve Precision Plastics of Indiana, Inc. and grant an additional year of abatement?
Approved.
So moved.
So moved.
Sorry.
Motion by Jennifer, seconded by Tad. We'll go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad? It is unanimous of those present. Next up is personal property for Precision Plastics. Any questions on that one? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve Precision Plastics of Indiana, Inc., their personal property abatement, and grant an additional year of abatement?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Jennifer. Go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. Does Precision have two properties, personal properties? Yes. Okay. Next one is the, this will be the 2017-17 one for personal property for Precision Plastics. Any questions about that one? Okay. Hearing none, do I have a motion to approve Precision Plastics of Indiana for their personal property abatement from 2017 and grant an additional year of abatement?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jennifer, seconded by Jenny. Go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. Next up is Kyocera for personal property. Any questions on this one? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve Kyocera SGS Precision Tools, Inc. and grant an additional year of payment?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Jennifer. Further discussion? Let the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. Next up is Kyocera personal property. Two different personal properties. Yep, this is the next one. Okay, any questions on this one? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve the personal property abatement from 2020 for Kyocera FGS Precision Tools, Inc. and grant an additional year of abatement?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, second by Jennifer. Further discussion? All those in favor should be, oh, I'm sorry, voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
And Tad? It's unanimous of those present. Okay. Good job, everybody. Next up, Ordinance 2022-13. Do I have a motion to read by title only?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, second by Jennifer. Further discussion? I guess I should probably do voice vote on this one too, since we're at it. So, voice vote, Jenny.
Approved.
Jennifer.
Approved.
Walt.
Approved.
Tad. Approved. Please read Ordinance 2022-13 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-13. This ordinance, if adopted, will replace Chapter 73, Section 73.35-6 73.99 of the City of Columbia City, Indiana Code of Ordinances to authorize the operation of golf carts and certain utility vehicles from city to city.
So I think, so obviously this is the amendment to the golf cart and the UTV, if you will, ordinance. We had that up on the agenda last time. Questions, comments, concerns about it at this point? Okay. Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve ordinance 2022-13 on second and final reading?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. Further discussion? Go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. Next up is ordinance number 2022-14. Do I have a motion to read by title only?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. Further discussion? Go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
Please read ordinance number 2022-14 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-14, an ordinance amending the rates charges for the City of Columbia City Municipal Electric Utility.
Outside of needing an ampersand or something like that. I said outside of needing an ampersand, the rates and charges. So as a reminder, this is the House Bill 1002 that was passed that eliminates the Indiana Utility Receipts Tax by the Indiana General Assembly. This is a mandate, not an option, but it does need to be changed in our ordinances. As a reminder, the utility receipts tax is a pass-through. We charge it to the customers, we collect it, and send it to the state. So it doesn't really impact us, but it does impact our rate customers. So any concerns, questions about that? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve ordinance number 2022-14 on second and final reading?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jenny, second by Jennifer. Let's go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. Next up is ordinance number 2022-15. Do I have a motion to read by title only?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. We'll go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
Please read ordinance number 2022-15 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-15, an ordinance amending the rates and charges for the City of Columbia City Municipal Water Utility.
Same thing, but on the water side. Any questions about that? Okay, hearing none. Do I have a motion to approve ordinance number 2022-15 on second and final reading?
So moved. Second.
Motion by Jennifer, second by Jenny. We'll go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Walt?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
It is unanimous of those present. Bravo, ladies and gentlemen. Bravo. With that, I think that's all we have for voting things, right? Wait.
I did get the one more at the end of this.
Okay.
But I didn't, without looking at it,
is the former Dunham's. Did we actually have that switched over to
Stadium? Yeah. Okay. We did that last year. This is their last year of
abatement, isn't it? I believe so. It was a 13 resolution.
Yeah, so this
will be their last year, right? Okay. You guys look at that second real quick. Got it.
So the boy count went up. That's a double.
20 doubles is expensive. So, I think that's what that happened. Well, and they would be at, what, 10% now?
Do you have a sense of going on there?
But I
Ted, this is the best I can do for you. Right there. Just to give you a couple things, so estimated number of employees was at 30, and it's actually at, I think that's 80, 60 or 80, I can't tell. I can get my teeth out, okay. The salary's estimated at 430, and it's now at 776,000. So. Yes. Okay, so, I guess, everyone's okay with this, what, JV Investments? We just passed that. Okay. Do I have a motion to approve JV Investments and grant their final year of abatement?
So moved.
Second. Motion by Jenny, second by Jennifer. Further discussion? Go to the voice vote. Jenny?
Approved.
Jennifer?
Approved.
Wolf?
Approved.
Tad?
Approved.
Thank you. Okay. Okay. Thank you, Dale. Have fun. Okay. You can go if you need to, or you don't have to. It's up to you. So, staff department. You guys didn't need anything from council, right?
I have a retiring employee.
Oh.
July 1st.
Okay.
So, right, Commissioner Bill, what was it?
That's actually, it's park board.
So,
yeah. You're good. Yeah. But, is there something else you need from Jenny before she leaves? No, remember, no, because our rule is you have to be three present in order to conduct.
Right.
Yeah. So, right. I mean, he can vote now because we have three present. But I guess my question is, do you need Jennings or anything to vote on? Because if not, it's just a final report from that on.
Okay. Yeah, no, it's just reports.
You're good. Thank you. Thank you. Okay.
Thanks for stopping by.
We are voting.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay.
Enjoy the one.
I'm going to put a light around and see if this is going to help.
Probably the best I can do right here. Okay. Department reports, Mark.
So, baseball, softball, still going on both Monday through Thursday nights. Then we have tournaments on weekends, so that keeps us busy. Concession stands staying busy. We've restriped some parking lots, which has helped a lot. The Black Center opens Saturday. I met with Musco Lighting yesterday about our field lights in the hopes that here in the future we can potentially do some work with our field lights there. We've got a really in bad shape. Our fireworks are July 3rd, which they have been every year for 19 years. Yeah. We had a training for our Aquatic Center staff on Sunday. Went really well. Kyle Weagle did a great job with that. Been mowing and spraying. 5-year plan for the parks is complete. JPR is going to start doing some engineering for Eagle Park, which will be great. Tad and I have been working with an engineer to do some potential pricing for a new auditorium to see if that's anywhere possible at all. We had a playground inspection at Kenneth Wright Park on Friday to look at the playground that was put back up there. I don't have his report back yet, but just kind of interested to see what he comes up with there. And the playground at Every Kid's Dreamlands, we're missing some bolts that were taken from there, so we're waiting for that others to come in before we can fix them. It's not like bolts that you can buy at Ace Hardware. They're specific to playgrounds. As I mentioned, we do have an employee retiring July 1st, so hopefully I'll be looking to replace that person too. And then we did get a pretty good deal on a digital sign for Eagle Park. We got this from LT Foundation, the sign that they had out in front of their place there by Buha. We have that. When we get possession of our new office there at the Community Foundation, that's when we'll be putting that sign in it. So,
questions on Mark? Thank you. Mike?
We had our yearly green inspections. We're going to replace some tenants. Instead of replacing grounds every single year, we're going to put new control boxes on all our drains that are outside. I had a kickoff meeting for the Fourth Street project with Donahue on the 19th. Provided them with all the information. soon. We walk both sites and those and things like that. So they're that good to go on that. They actually sent me revised survey and soil borings to the two companies for the sites today. They revised after we got our walkthrough. Tipping buckets for the long-term control plan. They were all three of them that are out there were not functioning. That was under warranty. Those have been repaired and then re-inspected by my staff. So that restarted a one-year warranty on all that equipment. That will expire May 18th of 2024. Our agreed order with IDEM for our toxicity reduction. We're in the closeout process. We passed all our testing, done everything that they wanted us to do. We're just waiting on our closeout paperwork, and then we'll go back to every 6 months we'll have to do a test, which will put us either October or November of this year, and then January 1st our new permit will take over, so then we'll go back to once a year testing at that point. I got approval tonight from the Board of Works to engage Midwest Engineering for the design and repairs of the CSO-19 the treatment plant. And that's all I have.
Questions? Thank you. Mark?
Can I just, I forgot to state that the splash pad also opens Savage. And so it's always the same as the pool memorial thing again. We do have some features that are not working properly in the winter. So it will work, it'll come on, but some of those features will have to shut off. So until we get them fixed, we'll just kind of not be completely working right. So, but it'll be working, just not all the features.
Okay, thank you, Mike.
We've got the sidewalk on Jefferson Street repaired or replaced. We're going to put the new main in on North Street up by Pinecrest. We've cleaned that ditch up so the water's flowing. Also, my dad's driving through through Eagle Glen, and I noticed a guy working on sprinklers, and he was turning it on. So I came to my back to the office and talked to the guy who was doing the turn-ons that day, and I said, "Hey, was you informed to turn this sprinkler on?" He said, "No, don't know nothing about it." So I said, "We'll get in the truck." We ran out there and we talked to the guy. I said, "Did anybody call up the office to say turn this on?" He said, "I think the owner did." I said, "We don't have no record of it." Come to find out, I believe they were $1,500 behind. They had been turning it on since 2017, us not knowing it. Now we find there's five or six more that they've done that to. So we've got, you know, and I guess what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to lock them off when we shut them off. Rosie, I have a question. On them meters, do they pay on a sprinkler meter? Do they pay a minimum?
Or is just when it's on.
Just when it's on.
Yeah, if it's shut off, they don't pay.
That's okay. Because I didn't know if they paid a minimum on the sprinkler meter.
So we lost all those minimums. And we, I think Natalie did talk to the person that's been turning on.
Yeah. They have their own shutoff. Where when they call and tell us to turn it on, we can turn it on, and they've got a shutoff. That's the only shutoff they shouldn't mess with, not ours.
So just to be clear, though, they've been paying for that water that they've been using.
Well, they're going to pay for the water.
Okay, so we went back.
So this is
their history.
But this is a so this doesn't come off their primary tap of the water line. There's a secondary tap off the water line that goes to the sprinkler system. The yard.
There's no sewage on there.
Sure, I understand that. I guess what I was just saying though is it's not coming out of the primary water line. So all this time that they have been sprinkling their lawns, they have not been paying a dime for it.
Exactly.
Which goes toward our line loss, which ends up hurting everyone, every other customer in the city of Columbia City.
Now, where we've lost, we're going to recoup because we know how much water they've used. They're going to get backbilled that. And some of them are going to be really complaining, so you guys might get a call on it. But they were never paying for their sprinkler service for 2-3 years.
Mm-hmm. So the guy who turned it on and turned it off, he did that on his own, or did he do it at the request of the people who...
The request of the homeowner.
The homeowner. Okay.
So what we lost, as Rosie was saying, we lost all the minimums, you know, while they're on. And I don't know what that would be, but it, you know, any losses, it hurts us.
What questions after that salary report? Thank you. Gary?
I'll see if I can make it better.
Thank you. That'd be great.
So we had officers out at the live firing range this last week and able to do some live fire, and they really enjoyed that due to finally getting some ammo in and the cost of it being so high. It allowed them to go out there and shoot quite a bit, actually, so they were some good feedback on that, and they felt good with that, so they were happy. Received 22 applications. One was eliminated almost immediately due to the fact that he didn't meet the perf requirements for age. So we was down to 21. We had 2 no-shows, 1 withdrawal. 3 from the physical agility were eliminated and 3 from the written. And then we have two laterals. So we've got 11 people going to interviews next week or the following week. So looking forward to that. 11 people probably more than we had last time that we had an open process. So I think we only had 11 last time in the beginning, so I was pleased with that. First Fridays in Farmer Market went very well. The police department had the K-9 unit out there as well as the drone, and the public was really interested in both of those, so that was a good turnout for us. Letters have been sent or hand-delivered to residents, reference their junk/trash in the front yards, and we give them 10 days to clean that up. In our Spillman system, we have a reoccurrence that will pop up when the 10 days is up, and it reminds us to go out and double check that and make sure the stuff's cleaned up. So that should be cleaned up here within the next week or so. So looking forward to that. Council or Board of Works did approve us to purchase 2 new vehicles. They found 2 vehicles out of statewide, out of Ohio. They were $35,000 plus a piece, so we were able to get those. And out here at City, there was the last I checked was like $37,000, $38,000, and we looked at Highland Dodge, and their Durangos were like $41,000, so we're saving a considerable amount of money. Just luckily, we found these actually. So
these are Explorers.
Yes, they're 2022s. Dispatch, we had a meeting yesterday for the dispatch, very well. I think everybody seemed very pleased with how things are going, so happy there. My wife Heather was so gracious to go buy gift cards and stuff. I was able to hand out to everybody as far as appreciation week that happened a couple weeks ago for communications. So she brought them to me, so that was great. Rachel completes her training by the end of this month, which then will start the split shift, which will then cover vacations and personal days and sick days and such. So that should cut down considerably on the overtime. So I think that's going to be a big savings because we go through a lot of overtime. Ed has went and took a course and is certified as a trainer now. Not going to do it though. Hopefully we don't have to use that, but he is now certified as a trainer, so things are going well.
Questions here? Thank you. Tom?
I did take Felicity Clark, our new hire, over the break, and you actually got her uniforms and things like that. We'll get a sized up this year here shortly. Get that on there because last we heard it was, last I heard was a 13 month wait to turn up here. So we will have to put her in new stuff until we get her new gear in. So that's exciting. Our process currently is in play. We're taking applications on the which is this Friday. We'll see how many applications we have then and decide whether we need to extend that or not. So I think it's one pretty good.
Thank you. Terry.
We made a lot of progress on the free Wi-Fi network down in town. We're hoping that'll be complete pretty soon, except for the missing parts that we're showing back there.
Questions? Thank you. Chip.
Westgate should be starting possibly the end of this week, for sure next week due to the retention bond. We'll be moving forward with that.
Are we going to have anything else? Marcia, Rosie. For your information, Sean has, they're working on some street lighting. Obviously, the lights out here, they're working to get those replaced once the concrete's all poured and all that kind of stuff. Obviously, you've seen the street department has been out there and they're working on that. They're hoping that the folks can get in sometime this week, but it's supposed to be in there this week, so we'll kind of see where that goes. But I anticipate that that project hopefully will be moved up here sooner rather than later. I'm hopeful it'll be done by first Friday, at least the main portion will be done by first Friday, but it's going to be real tight. So, which means it probably won't happen. So Sean has been working with Terry and with Kelly on, there's a ramp that's at the southwest corner of Chauncey and Van Buren that there's actually an electrical box there that we need to make a connector in order to do the Wi-Fi portion of the Wi-Fi project. So they got to kind of hammer that out anyway. So there's that ramp is not in great shape, so we're going to go ahead and just re-pour that ramp and get that up to standard, if you will. Sean also worked with Staffco on downsizing their transformer because they've really been at the minimums from the beginning. So downsizing their transformer because they really need that transformer over at Kyocera at the new profit. So it's a good use of helping one company to help another company, and so that's really good. During Board of Works, we approved accepting the kind of second phase, if you will, of Quessy's sewer project. You may remember, the first phase of Quessy's sewer project, they're already our customers, but the second phase that the Regional Sewer District is going to be doing, they're going to build that out purely out of grant money and then hand over the infrastructure to us. So these individuals will become our customers. In exchange for that, we're waiving our $13,000 tap fee. So we get $1 million in infrastructure for basically 13 grand, which is a pretty good deal. We also approved some street patching and paving just around the city that we hope will be done by September. Because we obviously want to move the crap out of our roads. So we're trying to get that in here as well. As well as doing a community crossings grant for next year as well. So, I think that's probably all I have. My voice is barely here. Well,
Rosie, you probably can answer this for me. But are we, from a cost perspective, with the people who have tall grass and the city says that we're going to come out and mow it? Is that a flat rate or is that an hourly rate, time and material?
I think we believe an hourly.
It's an hourly rate.
Okay, so.
But a minimum of an hour.
Huh?
A minimum of an hour.
It's a minimum of an hour. But most of the time it takes more than that just because it's so tall.
Yeah. But we charge them for the manpower as well as the equipment usage?
Yeah.
And, I mean, with gas, it's worth that. I mean, it sounds petty, but you get 5 gallons of gas.
Yeah.
It adds up, throughout the week,
And again, Mike's point's valid, is they, you know, they're behind the eight ball before they even get started.
Oh, yeah.
And is that a state rule that we have to wait X amount of days, or is that something that we pass locally?
I think it, if I remember correctly, I think it's a scenario where we have to wait for them to be notified, then there is a certain amount of days, I think. But you may remember we did change the ordinance from 10 inches down to 8 inches because when it got to 10 inches, then they had another 10 days. So we tried to shrink that so that at least we tried to stay ahead of it.
I'd have to read the ordinance. It's in the ordinance. I don't have that memorized.
Well, I know the ordinance. Is it? But the state doesn't mandate that there's a, like a waiting period between the violation and the remedy.
The problem is we're getting some places 2.5-3 foot tall before we get in our mower. You can't see what's in there.
Yeah.
And it's damaging my mower.
Yeah.
So if there's damage to the equipment, is that billable back to whoever owns it? Because we're in there, the bank or mortgage company or the homeowner, because you know we can go in there and ruin a mower deck or blades or
yeah,
and I'm just
well we should be able to do that. I mean I don't know that it's written exactly in the ordinance, but okay. I could see if it's expenses as well. I mean okay. That's certainly an expense.
Okay,
I mean one yeah go ahead, I'm sorry.
I just don't know what it says.
I was going to say one thing we definitely could do is you know we could obviously ask our chief of police to. You know, have a greater emphasis, if you will, by the officers of looking for those high weeds. I know that I saw one on Washington Street today, and I mean, they're out there for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, and some got so, signs, some yep. don't have signs, and some of them got a sign in it, but you can't see it.
those are the ones that are Mike's trying to get into mow, typically,
yeah.
if they have a sign that you can't see it.
Again, this is maybe an exceptional year, but it just seems like we haven't really talked about that topic for quite a while, and I know that you know they have X amount of days, and then we have to wait till we get a certified letter replying.
We have one lot. I want to bring this up again down here by Marshall. I don't think it's big enough anybody can build on. And I think the last time we looked, the back taxes are like $30,000, if not a little more. Nobody's going to buy it. Is there any way we could talk to that two homeowners and see if we can't do something where they take that over, one of them or both of them? At least it would be back on the tax roll that
yeah.
someone paying.
Yeah, and maintaining. I don't necessarily know if we as a city would have issues with that. I mean, obviously, that would be, we would basically waive off all of our fees that we've incurred. The issue I would say is that historically, no disrespect to our friends at the county, but historically, the county has not really been willing to write off anything or expunge, let's say, tax issues in order to get those problems solved. And I say that by also saying, our redevelopment commission literally had to go to court with the county to write off the LML taxes. So
you know, maybe they should take their turn mowing something.
Sure, I don't disagree with you.
You know, if they're worried about their money, and like I said, it's not big enough to put a house on.
Yep, I know. Yeah, I don't think it's a bad idea for sure. I mean, the owner of the property, I think, is in Fort Wayne, if I remember correctly. But
I don't even know
it. So at least it was at one time. So
yeah, I know that's good.
Well, it's the cost of the nuisance abatement. So if we damage equipment, I would say my argument would be that's a part of the cost of the nuisance abatement because we're having to abate their problem, and if we damage our equipment doing it because of their property, I think we throw that right into the cost.
There you go, Randy.
Is it damaged yet?
Hey, Mike.
What?
Is it damaged yet? Or
have we damaged the mower?
Well, yeah. What we usually do is cut a tire. You know, we have to buy a new tire or something like that.
So we need every time, whenever when that happens, we need to take the property information and give that to Rosie because we'll charge that back to the property.
Okay.
And, you know, there wouldn't be a problem in mending that slightly.
to say the cost of abatement shall include and not be limited to these things. And that way, if somebody came in, we could say it's right there in the ordinance.
Yep.
Do you want me to do
that?
I think that's a good
adjustment.
Okay. I'll adjust it.
This all comes back to, at the end of the day, just for the public purpose, this all comes back to, this is your money that we're having to spend because people don't take care of their own property. And that people could be residents, renters, or banks, you know? So just keep that in mind. This is not something we're trying to penalize anybody. We're trying to make sure that we protect our taxpayers and the dollars that they, you know, give to us, if you will. So.
And I think, who's the inspector from the county for the roads and stuff?
So that'd be health inspector. That'd be Scott Wagner.
Scott Wagner. I know once or twice he's been in various places over the years where a wind is busted out and they can see animals getting into the house. Again, something might add to that list of unsafe conditions or something. Or have him come down and do it. But thank you for discussing it.
We have no audience or press, so we'll call the meeting adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike.
Thanks, Mike. Yeah.